Hey everyone, this is the last video where we'll be talking about the last batch. So if you're following my video in a hierarchical order, by now you might have got all the badges except the Pair Extraordinaire. If you haven't watched the other videos, just go beyond in the playlist. You will be able to see all the videos over here. Now, Pair Extraordinaire is a badge where you show that, okay, your commits involve multiple collaborators. Now, how you can get this badge is pretty much very simple. What you can do is like you already created your own special readme profile, as you see. So go to that special readme profile which you created, copy this clone into your local system. So I have already cloned this over here. If you don't know how to clone it, so what you do is like type cmd over here, command prompt. So this will open command prompt in this particular directory. Sorry about that. In this particular directory, then just type git clone and paste the URL. So this will create a copy of your repository like this. Now again, open the command prompt and you need a Visual Studio Code for this, right? So to open Visual Studio Code on this particular file path, just type code space dot. So this will open a Visual Studio. Now over here, you will be see the entire file directory and the file which you currently open, which is this one. And here is the output, how it looks like. So this is much more easy way to update your readme profile rather than on the GitHub page. Now just give git pull, just make sure that okay, you are in the current branch properly. So you can see you are on the current branch and there is nothing else to commit. Now check your branch, git branch, make sure that you have created your own branch. You can do that using git checkout p then your branch name. For example, if I want to create in a some branch called feature Sanjay, now I switch to feature Sanjay. So git branch, now you are on your branch. Now you can go here and do some changes. For example, I had space over here, remove the space, join my open source community. I have done that. Now what I can do is like always make sure that you go over here. Sorry about that. You go over here and select git bash. Now we will be working on the git bash. Once you click on the git bash, what happened is like there will be a dollar sign appear over here. So what you need to do is like git add star, which will eventually add all the changes which you have been committed right now. Now git commit m and quotation added readme file. Now make sure that you press shift enter and again shift enter, shift enter. Now you type co-authored by, now you can just enter space Sanjay KV, that's my name and that's my GitHub URL. So then what you will be doing is like put this bracket, enter my email ID. You can use my same email ID for this, gmail.com. Do this, shift enter, co-authored by again. Now you have to enter your profile ID for here. For example, I'm using this particular thing. So J capillator, I-S-H-A-T-R, all right? J-I-S-H-A-T-R, all right? Make sure that everything, whatever you see capital letter, that should be in the capital letter. Whatever you see in the small letter, that should be in the small letter. So my account is in the small letter, all right? So that should be something which you have to take a note of. Again, space, you have to enter your email ID over here, gmail.com, all right? Now close the quotation. So now you have done this thing and click on enter. One file has been changed. So check the branch again. So you are working on git feature Sanjay. So push that branch, git push feature Sanjay. Could not read from the please make sure you have the correct access right and the repository exit. So I think I made some mistake over here. Feature Sanjay. Let me try it again. Git push feature Sanjay. All right, let me figure it out what's going wrong over here. So I think I missed something over here. Let me close this one so you can have a full view. So git push origin. I missed the origin. Oh, they don't let me paste. So maybe I can type feature Sanjay. So it should work right now. All right, so the thing has been pushed into my main repository. Let me go and see. So here you can see compare and pull request is opened on my particular repository. Now here you will be able to see the changes. Now you can see this thing. So this is what I was talking about. If you did it correctly, you will be able to see these two icons instead of one icon. So which says that, okay, multiple people has been collaborated. So when the moment when you create a pull request right now, you can see this has been updated. So all of these commits was like a single commit. So you can add multiple people, as many as you want, who is collaborated. So GitHub want to teach you how to do a co-authored commit. That's why they will launch this particular batch. And if you're working in a very big organization where you have to do a single task with multiple collaboration, you can do this. So you're giving them a rights that, okay, you've been collaborated as well. Now, the moment I do squash and merge, you can see this has been updated like this, and delete the branch. And go to your pull request. You can see the last commit, which you have two people like this. So it should appear. If it don't appear, you made some change mistake in the commit history. For example, if I open my Visual Studio Code, you made some mistake over here, how you added the co-author commit. So I will copy the exact code over here. So I make sure that you push the changes into the open the GitHub bash and you do exactly like this. You can use my email ID if you don't have any friends who can do the same for you. And the second one, you should use your name, right? And make sure that, okay, the capital letter and any small letter is available over here. So that's the one thing which you need to look into it. And once this is done, what you need to do, you have to go over here. Just try to refresh the page. You will be able to see the badge appearing over here. Usually sometimes it takes some time to appear that badge in your profile. Okay, so this was instant. So you can see the GitHub co-authored profile is open in your profile. Now the amazing fact is, like, I did it on my repository and I just added this person's name. So this person has not been contributed. So once you do co-authored name with another people name, so it will appear in their profile as well your profile. For example, if you look into my profile right now, it's still loading for me. Yeah, over here. So you can see somebody has did the same way into my repository where they collaborated with one of the machine learning repo, and she added me as a co-author. So now this was my as per the rule, it should be 10th repository who do pair extraordinate. So when somebody else also do it, you will also get the badge perks and it can increment. So that's how the things work. So I hope this entire video was very useful for you to understand some basic concept of GitHub achievement badge. Again, I'm just stressing you out. The right way to earn badges is like, do it in a normal open source way. These badges will come automatically to you. So as a beginner, just to motivate you towards the open source community, I'm just telling you how to get this particular badge and make your profile somewhat better, right? So let me refresh in the video and see whether the sponsor badge has been appeared for him, because in the last video I sponsored him. All right. So thank you for watching the video. Bye.